done. There's a guy you might have heard of, whether you're a baseball fan or not. Go by the name of Yogi Berra. He said a little something once. It ain't over till it's over. That's damn right. All right. You're not here for that. You're here because you got a weird sense of humor or something weird about you. I don't know. And you're just another freak in the freak kingdom, as Hunter S. Thompson would say. All right? You found the right place. If you're a reader of Hunter S. Thompson, you're definitely in the right place. I should mention that more often. Okay? You know, Hunter's whole take on American culture and pop culture back in his day and time. I'm doing something similar here, but instead of writing for Rolling Stone, I have a YouTube channel for a couple of hundred subscribers. I make observations. I crack witty little jokes with a little social commentary sprinkled in. And I do that all through the magic of home shopping networks. We're going to watch some home shopping tonight. Oh, and I'm filled with fear and loathing. Actually, the fear is gone. The fear was while I still lived in the States. I was able to leave the fear behind. I'm just left with the loathing. So I'm halfway there. Hey, Lola, and I'm glad that you gave it a shot that to see if the stream would be on tonight. And it is ladies' night in the house. Holy cow. I better open up the Discord here behind the scenes. It's just Steve and the ladies. You know what? This is part ladies. I need to be pampered. I need to be pampered, and I need like the full like, what are those giant like palm tree leaves or whatever? I need some of that. Anybody got any grapes? Anybody got grapes out there? By the way, how's the microphone sounding? Does it sound like it's got a little weird echo or reverb or anything? And also I want to check the lag, because the lag was a big issue earlier. Please type in this number as soon as humanly possible. That number is 4. Please type in the number 4 if you don't mind. Wow. Okay, so apparently the stream just wanted to blow while I watched the most heartbreaking baseball game of my life. And now we're back to normal. I guess I'm in my zone. This is where I'm supposed to be. I've carved out a life of reacting to home shopping channels, and this is my fate. I'm just trying to close this. Okay, save. Yeah, all right. I just close. I don't. Okay, great. Save. I just close. Okay. Here we go. Hey, be my friend. I'm sure plenty of people here would love to be your friend, assuming, you know, you're a person of friend-like qualities. It's a friendly chat here. We like to crack jokes, but we're overall well-intended. All right, we're going to dive in, I guess. I have no idea. It's been a while, and maybe just everybody who follows my stream just realize that Steve was probably going to be out of commission over the weekend, so no point in checking in with him. But normally I get a update from somebody about whether or not Tony and Michelle are going to be on. Oh, it's K-Tron. How about that? Oh, you know what? The Heyo, I guess that is that it's a trademark. And here I was thinking maybe I had a new watcher of the stream. That looks like Michelle's hand. I could be mistaken. It looks pasty enough. And I'm thinking we got Michelle.
Is your octagon. Now, an octagon,
that's her,
to me is just a party on the hand.
Oh, well, I'll be right there. I'll be right there.
With an octagon, all the
no worries.
Facets inside, the boom, light just bounces and it has a big old time. Look at that. You see?
We are underway, and look at the crud. Whoa, what happened? Look at the crud in the cracks of these nails. Folks, you gotta keep that clean. All right. I hope I hear Tony quickly, because I want to be able to count these nails if they're on our bingo card tonight.
Some Robin's Egg Blue.
But I can't break out the card until I hear Tony. I'm in a conundrum.
Pink and purple and crushed velvet.
Uh-oh.
And
who's in the Discord?
Lavender and red and pink. You see,
Katron is back in the soundboard. What's he up to?
You all pay the same price no matter what.
No matter what.
Looky, looky.
Okay, I'm clearly going to have to run this back 2 minutes. Just, I need Tony.
Here is your...
Where are you, Tony?
...appraisal on the octagon. Hello, $9,100. Here is your appraisal on the first option. 12 large, and that's conservative.
All right, I'm getting concerned, because I can only... let it play so much before I got to get back to the crud. Yeah, but I'm just going to go out on a limb and say Tony's there. I'm just going to go out on a limb and say he's there. Let's open a card. If he's not there, then we'll just play the other bingo. I just want to get this crud in, because that's a good shot of the crud. Actually, I think it was a different shot than this, but whatever. Come on. I just trimmed my nails right before I started the stream. I took a look and I said, yep, if I'm not going to bother shaving yet another day, I should at least trim the nails. So I did do that much. Let's see what we got tonight. Oh, wait, that's not what I'm looking for. Why are we going to this? Bingo Baker, this page cannot be found. What are you talking about? Oh, I left one number off on the link. It's hiding. Okay, that two there. You see, I can't get to it without that little... God damn it. All right, I'll just add a two. I'll add a three and a two to whatever I'm putting in here. Stand by, folks, for my ineptitude. Okay, a three and a two and a one and a enter. All right, Thunder Bingo 3.0. Here we go. Come on, show. Yes, fingers not fit, jumping out on the page. We'll see what else. Oh, and I think she has two rings on. Okay. Hey there, D telephone number zip code guy. How you doing? All right, I'm going to... Oh, we have a whammy on the board, however. There is a wrench in the works, folks. Whammy on the board. We got to work around it. I think we can do it. Here are tonight's squares. Are you ready? Tony drops the price super fast, not giving us time to do a pricing game. Final price is not the final price. Final price is less than 10% the starting price. Tony pretends to give the wrong price. I sense a theme up here in this first row. Tony puts his hands together in prayer. Tony regrets letting Michelle go off the rails. Tony gives a Brazilian version of a figure of speech. Smackdown music, please. Michelle displays two or more rings on her finger at the same time. Marsha, we'll see. Entire broadcast has 8 straight seconds of dead air. Again, if we find out Tony's not there, we just quickly move on and bring up a card for QVC. Caller count less than 4. Ladies and gentlemen, request to an assistant goes unfulfilled. Tony or Michelle docks a customer. Michelle has what could be mistaken to be an orgasm. Fingers not fit for TV. Production issue. Lights, camera, graphics. He is on. Lola just checked. Okay, we got a whammy. KK Isu. Deal of a lifetime or once in a lifetime deal. Tony lies about announcing the wrong price. Wait a minute. We got a problem. This is the same. When I put this together, I did a bad job of looking over everything. Tony lies about announcing wrong price is the same as Tony pretends to give the wrong price, isn't it? That's the same damn thing. All right, well, we've got a game. I guess it balances out. We have a whammy that screws us on one side, but we also have a square that works two times over, okay? I say that evens itself out in terms of fairness. You know? We just got to hope we get that square. Awkward flirting between the hosts. Buy two to sell one scheme and talk of cows or bulls. If we see a calculator, that's a free square. We'll also be playing pricing games, hopefully, many of those, if we can, and keep the literally count going. And, yeah, let's see. We got Tony, apparently, and we got Crud. Whoops, excuse me. That's my knee hitting the... Why is this playing? I'll just leave that paused. Okay, so the Crud is been accounted for, and we are underway. All right, all right, all right. Take it away, Michelle.
Have a look at that, because with an octagon, all those elongated facets inside, the light just bounces and it has a big old time. Look at that.
Well, light it had a big old time. It's having a gay old time.
You see pink and purple and crushed velvet and...
Oh, look at that. Looky there. Looky there, folks. It's almost as if I took a screenshot of this earlier. Just purple instead of blue. Oh, that was a good idea. Not only was it a good idea for a square, but it's a picture square. I like picture squares. Makes it fun. And the same polish. Yeah, it's very fantastic. All right.
And red and pink. You see all kinds of stuff. Now the oval's gone.
Yeah, if you take LSD first.
Gone, but you all pay the same price. No matter what, and...
What is going on with the accent tonight?
Here is your appraisal.
She's laying it on a bit thick tonight, folks.
Octagon. Hello, $9,100. Here is your appraisal on the first option. 12 large, and that's conservative.
Katron back with a little avatar name that I can trust.
$12,000.
How you doing?
So, if you...
We've already got a couple squares knocked off, and we haven't even heard from Tony yet, so we're doing just fine.
You get...
Oh,
you can
God.
Buy four, almost five of these for the very low appraisal.
Guys, just to put it out there, I might not be able to make it 2 hours. I already did a four-hour stream. I'm exhausted.
Even on
talking for 4 hours.
9,100, option one.
I'm used to talking for two. For four, it's tough. Now I'm making it six in one day.
You could buy three.
I'm not complaining. I'm just trying to keep you guys from feeling let down when I put on a half-assed show here.
On a crazy low price.
Lola, that's fine, but the calculator, the COWulator that we need for that free square is it's its own special thing. You'll know it when you see it. I think it's more of a graphic than a physical calculator. It's a very rare find. It's like a rainbow. It really is. Hopefully we'll see one.
Crazy low price.
Ah, shit. Thank you. Well, it just speaks to my level of talent and charisma that I can put on a half-ass show and you guys love it. That just... I mean, I'm just oozing with talent and charisma. What do you want me to do? You know?
Liar! Liar! Liar!
Crazy low. Wow. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Which to buy? I do not know. Whichever one you
catch
like.
Catch a Tony
most.
By the toe.
That's it. Dollar is to it.
I know what version of eeny, meeny, miny, mo Michelle grew up with. And no, I can't say that version on YouTube.
We've got all kinds of messages coming in.
Nor would I say it in any other situation.
Oh, Scott. Thank you, Scott.
Wait a minute. Did we have an orgasm? Hold on. Let's roll the videotape. Orgasm is on the board, right? Right here. Oh, my God. Oh, but look at that. Look at that. I'm thinking, oh, look at that. Look at that rogue going across. But there's a whammy. Did I really make that noise? Can we edit that out? Edit out that noise I just made.
Scott.
Right there. Is that orgasmic or not? I'll leave it up to the ladies. There's a lot of ladies in chat tonight. We got Marsha, we got Lola, we got Melinda, we got Amanda. A lot of ladies with A's on the end of their name. They should be weighing in. Is this an orgasm?
Scott, thank you.
Yeah, forget about how whatever she says after the sound. That's good enough for Amanda? All right. It sounds like went too early. Well, that's sometimes that happens. You have low expectations for a woman's orgasm. that's one way to look at it. I just know there's a prism of orgasms, you know. You got all kinds of variations, whether it be length or certain noises or certain words or. We could talk all night about every nook and cranny of every orgasm out there. Now, I mean, surely I would love a Meg Ryan When Harry Met Sally level orgasm from Michelle, but I don't think we can expect something like that. So we got to kind of take what we can get. That's why the square specifically says could be mistaken. Not Michelle has a clear orgasm. It could be mistaken for one. Maybe you heard it passing by and you're like, did that lady just come? You know? I'm going to go ahead and count that. All right.
Scott said he just purchased a Rhapsody Tanzanite piece. I will be one of your new investors. Love you guys. Well, we love you back. Thank you. And not because you're buying things, but we appreciate you. We would not be here without you. Miss Susan, please call your customer service representative or your personal shopper.
Is she doxing?
Came here to the desk, and I'm not able to look that up.
Who's Miss Susan?
I wish I could, but I.
Yeah, but I'm not sure that's doxing. I feel like we need like a town they're from or something. A little bit more info. Miss Susan just isn't enough. You know? It's not just the name. It's got to be a name plus some info. Uh-oh. That's latte condensation on the touchpad. Stand by. Regaining control. Okay.
I cannot.
I've heard him do that. I mean, we're gonna have to go with the spirit of the square. I mean, I can at a later date make it a little easier and just say mention their name, but I didn't think a name mention was rare enough to be board worthy. It seems kind of. I feel like that's all. We almost always get that. I mean, I'm sure you could say the same about. Oh, we always get. Are you ready? That's probably a given. I don't know. We got to go with the intent. I'm sorry. Again, I'm not going to be as adamant as I was about Tony slapping or pounding the table as being something frequent, but I've definitely have heard them give a little more info out about some of these customers. Like they might mention an area code they're calling from, you know? Calling from the 212, you know, something. So just a little bit of extra info other than just like a first name, you know? All right.
Shaughnessy said it's stunning. Yes, it is. Donna says, show us the calculator.
Oh, my God. Did somebody write in? No, because we're probably 15 minutes behind by now. The calculator! Free square! Free square! Oh my God! OMG is right, the calculator!
Shaughnessy said it's stunning. Yes, it is. Donna says...
Mark off the whammy, or, look, there's no rule saying we have to apply the free square the minute we get it. We can just pocket that mamma jamma, like a get-out-of-jail free card, and just apply it for the most sensible place to apply it. Let's not apply it now. Let's apply it when we need to apply it. Come on, Marsha. I'll tell you what, if we were on, like, Survivor, I don't know how long you'd be lasting, Marsha. I don't know.
Show us the calculator.
She was doing the thumb trick there at the bottom.
The calculator.
The bottom one's getting the thumb trick. Let me see if that's up here. I don't think so. And by the way, is Tony going to make an appearance?
Don't get him started on his calculator. Okay, all but the octagon remain.
But Lola, you would only be giving it to her so she could survive one more week. There's no reason to delay the inevitable.
Octagon, this is huge. Look at this. This is a big ring. I love an octagon cut. That's gorgeous. That octagon is a 9x7, 2 carat 69.
What's over here? Oh, that's a ring. What? What's in here? Like a sandbox? Is this like a litter box for like an ant? What the hell is this?
With 31 points of colorless and near flawless diamonds. That's amazing. That's beautiful.
How many times in
Tony's here.
Life, ladies and gentlemen.
I think I heard a ladies and gentlemen. Let me run that back.
Beautiful.
How many times in your life, ladies and gentlemen, have you...
He mumbled the hell out of it. You could hardly hear it, ladies, but he said it. He said it.
You walked...
All right. Let's see. That's right on half an inch if we count the diamond exterior or whatever the hell that border is. That's right on half an inch. Is that up on the board? Okay, so still, the calculator, by the way, this gets marked off because a calculator is still a talk of a cow. So we get that square, and then, yeah, now let's, we may very well use it on the whammy because we got a diagonal going like this, and we got this going like this. But yeah, we'll just keep that puppy on the side until it's time to unleash. So, no ruler measurement? Okay, just making sure.
Out of a store, knowing you purchased an item that should have been 4 times more expensive. 4 times more expensive.
Some cushion cake.
Because that's what you're getting when you purchase any one of these.
Oh, yeah.
And that's a very conservative appraisal. Now, let me say this to you guys, okay?
Go ahead, Tony.
Let me go back to that... I want to show you 2 comparisons.
Whoa.
On Tanzanite jewelry.
Picture in picture. This is new. I don't think I've ever seen this. Why have they never done this? I got to sit up. My posture is... This is the 7th hour in this seat that is not designed to be sat in for more than like a half hour at a time. My ass is feeling it. Ugh. I need a cushion cut for my ass. All right. What do you got, Tony?
I want to show you two. There's a 2-carat stone and there's a 1-carat stone. These are from a very big brand. And I want to make a comment that I read.
A comment.
In a recent article. Okay, let me show you these comparisons really quick.
You want to comment on a recent article and you're showing us this fake website thing. What article? What the hell are you talking about, Tony? Ah, boy. All right. Get ready for a lot of BS from Tony.
Comparisons, but they're references. They're smaller gemstones. Here's 10,000 for 1.25 carats and 46 points of diamonds. So about 1.7 carats, okay? 1.7 carats. Now let me show you the other one.
Guys, I gotta zone out listening to him talk with stuff like this. My mind is...
Ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we got that already, but we heard it clearly that time. Okay. I'm gonna roll a joint. I'm gonna go ahead and get that process started because it's probably gonna take me longer than usual to do anyway, given my state. So please, don't hesitate to shout out any bingo-related stuff happening that I might not catch. Thank you.
For 16,000. 18,600?
Yep.
Okay, 18,600 for 2 carats. Now, I'm not the brightest kid on the block, but 2,499 is a lot lower than 18,000. And a 4A is a lot more exclusive than a triple A. Now, that's a conclusion I can take.
People are still here, right? I haven't seen a new comment in like 3-4 minutes. Okay.
I've been in this business for 26 years.
Okay.
Tanzanite, apart from being limited, apart from being exclusive, apart from being everything else you can imagine, is absolutely beautiful, absolutely fascinating. I'm very surprised we have any of these left. That octagon, which is item number 2, how many of item number 2 do we have?
Ew, we don't have the square, but Tony, that's not good hygiene.
Cushion. The octagon, how many do we have?
Hey, Melinda, you know, Dennis Basso would never do something so crude.
Okay,
you'll never see me putting my finger in my mouth.
On that piece, okay? Really quick.
Someone else's finger, on the other hand, well, that's a whole different story.
Was appraised, ladies and gentlemen,
oh, God.
At 12...
Now I gotta
$1,000.
Now I gotta stop rolling this joint and address PAS. How you doing, PAS? Dude, what in God's name? I gotta do this, guys. I'm sorry. I'm doing my best. I did a 4-hour stream starting at 3 a.m. and I'm still coming at you with a 2-hour crazy ass bingo home shopping game thing. But me and PAS, PAS, you saw the game? Did you see maybe the most just mind-numbing decision-making by a manager when it comes to how to use the bullpen to get through 9 innings of a baseball game? By the time they got done, I'm looking... I couldn't tell the difference between the starting lineup and the pitchers we used because I think it was 9 apiece. We walked 11 batters. It was like the third most walks given up in a playoff game ever or some damn thing. We walked 11 batters. We walked Corey Seager 5 times. He's got a major league record. He's done something no one's ever done in the history of the game. He was walked 5 times by the Orioles pitching staff. It was an absolute train wreck on every level. And yet the Orioles still tried their best. The bats finally woke up. They put up 8 runs. But the pitching stunk so hard. And Hyde just kept trying to... He was throwing a middle reliever out in the second inning to replace Grayson Rodriguez. He didn't go to Flaherty or Gibson. He goes to a short reliever, and I'm thinking, okay, maybe he's doing this just to get out of this jam. And then maybe the other reason is, you know, a guy like Gibson might need extra time to get warm in the bullpen if he's going to come out and give us like 4 innings. But what does he do? Next inning, Jacob Webb. Inning after that, who was next? I mean, it was just, he thought he could just use 7 guys averaging an inning apiece. Oh my, it was a disaster. Okay. I've never seen a game. Look at the box score. Things just jump off the box score at you that go, I don't know if I've ever seen that before. Just absolutely bonkers.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry for that rant. I got it out of the way, and now I can continue. Good Lord.
12,000. Now take a look at that. That means your piece is about 1/5 of the price. 1/5 of the price.
Say it one more time. Oh, Tony. Wait, dead air. Dead air.
Think about that.
That wasn't 8 seconds.
Let me have an extra 4 minutes on this, please.
4 minutes, please. 4 minutes.
I don't know how this is still here. I really don't. wow.
So no response at all to that information if you didn't see the game. I mean, isn't that crazy? Or did I just completely abandon the show I'm doing to talk 5 minutes for no reason? I don't know. At this point, I'm on fumes, so apologies to anybody involved with what I'm doing. All right. Here we go.
What do you got?
Here we go.
What's
happening?
All right, have a look at that. So we have the octagon right here.
I'd love to get Tony in the octagon.
I don't know why this is still here. I would grab this like nobody's business. It's a stunning, stunning piece. It really is.
All right, you convinced me. I'll buy it.
And I say get it while the getting's good.
Should I get two? Maybe
that's
sell one?
There is to it.
What do you think?
Because this is not going to last long.
And yet you're delaying moving on.
The Tanzanites are not going to last long. It's as simple as
it seems to be lasting very long.
We cannot buy these again. We don't have another source for this material. and it is as simple as that. It's as simple as that. We don't have them.
Man, Catron made out like a bandit. Hello.
We had our head buyer come on and say, we do not have another source for this material. As far as...
if he bought five, can he make like a brass knuckle out of that?
As good as it gets.
Make some brass knuckles out of these.
I mean, this really is just an incredible opportunity.
Are you sure? It doesn't sound incredible, Michelle.
Okay, obrigado, ladies and gentlemen. The clock now is not your...
All right, when we have Giz Brazilian version of a figure of speech, are we allowed to use obrigado? Or is that just a word and not an actual figure of speech? Is that in the spirit of the square or not? I'll let everyone else decide.
Friend. I have done the best possible price.
All right,
on
so I guess that just, I guess that doesn't
not
count.
That I think it is the most important point in this presentation, but it is definitely.
I agree.
The final price on this on clearance should have been $2,799. I've taken
it could be.
The liberty to go $300.
I got a lot of Tony quotes already out there, though.
Item. That means I've done what no one should do because. Clearance is already the lowest possible price. Item number two and item number three, just so we're on the same page, cannot be replaced at that price. But it is what it is.
I hate that expression.
Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Why are you thanking me?
Wow. All right. And the cushion just popped back in. So if you were looking for option one, or right here, that cushion.
Yep, Tony is what he. I am what I am.
This is the. Hey,
Well, and blow me down.
3 carat 48.
Skip it a skin.
2 points of diamonds.
I'm gonna buy me
and
some tanzanite. Some tanzanite on sale.
Heck.
Looks interesting.
You couldn't buy
skibbity skin
for that. We've shown you platinum bands for $6,000, $7,000, $8,000. That's just nuts.
I'm Tony the jeweler thief. I'm Tony the jeweler thief.
That's just completely crazy. I would get
something's not right. There's all this tanzanite. I'm Tony the jewelry thief.
All right, out it goes. That's not going to stay around long.
Is it the Future War set we're on now? Why not?
Onward.
Maybe we'll get a Robert Zadar sighting. Michelle has no energy.
We're moving very fast. Go back over the last 25 items shown or call
moving
your
on. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Or your customer service representative and see if something that you were interested in is available. You never know. Okay, look at your personal.
Whoa, I've never seen this.
Oh my.
Holy Toledo, this is a moment in Shop LC Tony and Michelle history. Their own spinning wheel of garbage. Are they taking a note out of the, or taking out of the playbook from the Gem Network or whatever? Don't they know that they're the gold standard for selling jewelry and that other network is a complete joke? What are they doing here?
One is a beautiful ruby. Three is a gorgeous, gorgeous kunzite, sleeping beauty. You have morganite. Now look at this.
Look at what? Okay. For me, this would be jewelry that appears to be mating. I know it's a bit, it's kind of like spooning when you're banging sort of in that spooning pose. Kind of a like a side bang, but we don't have that on the board.
Okay.
They're holding more than that, Marcia, and I can see it. Look, as everything's a Rorschach test, all right, and I see nothing but banging everywhere I go.
This is a round.
I mean, look at that angle, all right? Maybe that angle is a little more revealing.
You have a round cut.
God. What am I
one
doing?
One price, one drop.
One price, three one minutes. Drop.
Smackdown music.
Oh, hold on. He hasn't dropped it. He says he's going to drop it once. Well, we got a price. We got a thing to bid on here. Hey, Benz. How you doing? Yeah, they got a spinning wheel of garbage. Can you believe it? What have they done? Get your bids in, folks. A $14,599. Is it a pair of rings? Or do you get your choice of two different designs? I don't know. Who gives a shit? Just do your damn best to guess at this stupid thing. All right. Everyone got a bid. I'm going to go with Katron, but I'm just going to remove the decimal point. There. Sort of a in honor of Katron, I'm bidding his same price, just removing a little dot. That's all. All right. Last chance to get your bid in. Melinda, you in earshot? Who else is lurking? All right, here we go.
Gentlemen, yes or no offer. We have 12 pieces, is that correct?
Yep.
How many pieces in the round?
Whoa, Tony. Whoa. Ooh, buddy. Wow. He is definitely going through different... Yeah, he was definitely wearing a wig that one time. There's no way his head looked like that. I guess he tried out a wig and then said, eh, I don't like this. I wouldn't either. I mean, God, wigs have got to be annoying to wear. You know?
Yeah.
Am I allowed to count 8 seconds of dead air if it's just the CNC Music Factory song playing? I guess technically that's not dead air. But at the same time, if I heard the air conditioning humming, I wouldn't say, you know, they're filling the air. I don't know. Tony can't decide what to eat for dinner. How would you feel if you had to go to work and rip off old people all day? I can't see the rest of your comment because of this heart in the way. Can't something that with a wig. What, can't do that?
Everybody dance now! Everybody dance now! Yeah!
I get nervous when he takes a long time to think.
Yeah!
Because without fail, I get a phone call.
Here is the go. Back with the bass. The jam is live in effect, and I won't waste time on the mic with a dope rhyme. Jump to the rhythm, jump, jump to the rhythm, jump. Let me see you move.
Dance to the right.
Move.
Watch me all night.
Everybody over here, everybody over there. Okay, we got hands in prayer. Tony, my God, people on the million-dollar question of who wants to be a millionaire don't take this much time. What do you need to do? Phone a friend? An ex-con friend? What do you got to do, Tony?
Are you ready?
Tony, you dick. You're the one delaying. Yeah, we're ready. You know what we're ready for? Besides the price? Anything. We're ready for you to do anything other than sit there like stewing over nothing. You complete whack job. I am ready. And I think it's on the board. Yes, it is. Okay. If Tony regrets Michelle going off the rails, we indeed will apply the free square we have on standby to the whammy. We're gonna get rid of that whammy. By the way, the B-52s have a song called Whammy, so I might have to bring that into play. Tony.
2,187. Go.
2187. And look at him. Look at him. Like, what are you, Saint Tony of Assisi? Like, get over yourself, Tony. Okay, 21. Who's closest? Is that Ben's off by 700, or is that me off by 800, I guess? I think Ben's has it by like 100.
3 minutes.
Wait a minute. He just said 3 minutes. What does 3 minutes mean? Could we get another drop? Did he announce it as a final price?
Before you send an email,
could it go below 10%?
With that price, let me save you some time. I don't know.
Oh, he did say one drop. So maybe, you know, he does lie sometimes about dropping the price only a certain amount of times. Maybe I should change one of these to Tony lies about the number of price drops to left or some shit. I don't know. Well, I'll worry about it later. Hey, Benz.
Okay.
Yeah, you won, but it's not guaranteed yet. We got to wait for the next item to know for sure. They might pull an okie doke on us.
Right, here you go. This is the oval. It is a 3.32 carat. You heard me. 3.32 carat. And look right here.
Looky here.
In full studio lighting where it should be washed out in light. You see that purple and pink. You also have 18 points
Show me the pink. Yeah, you're off by like 700 and I'm off by like 800. So, but the thing is, they might drop the price again and then suddenly somebody else might be the winner chicken dinner. You know what I mean?
E to F, colorless and near flawless diamonds. You have 4.68.
I'm not saying I'm trying to win.
950 platinum.
I know I'm out of it.
And you have an appraisal.
I'm saying somebody else could win.
Last year for $11,000. Now,
I don't know.
Really
I'm just saying, let's make sure it's the final price. Shit.
You have a round cut.
Let me check.
Three.
I thought
carats,
we had several bids
not
in there.
One, not two and a half. But
okay, Amanda bid five.
Nine
okay.
Millimeter.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Certified
Ben's
and appraised tanzanite with 30 points.
What do you call it?
Of E to F.
Unless
VS
there's some kind of unforeseen crazy event, you indeed won.
With an appraisal that was
and I'm very proud of you, Benz.
For
very
money.
Proud.
No. Just simply no. This is a fortune. They are both a fortune.
Got my own calculator.
But this is an oval and this is a round. You lose 30 to
this is the church and this is a steeple.
But
open the door and out come all the people.
Is you don't pay for what they is left over. You pay for what they started with.
By the way, guys, I know you're not super excited by anything I'm doing in terms of sports related stuff, but nice weekend. I think, remember I played 227 at the end of last week? 233. We're moving. We're shaking. We're shaking like your mama's bacon.
Beth, but not here. That doesn't live here. So you only pay for what you get, and
congrats.
You're not even paying for that.
It's a slow crawl, guys.
Wow.
Honestly, I shouldn't be getting a congratulations until I get to 1,000.
Five of them are gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, the round.
Oh, that was a harsh interruption.
Platinum.
That was a harsh interruption. Not on the board. Sorry.
And the best diamonds literally money can buy.
Oh, literally.
Are we kidding here?
Nope.
That's 3 carats in your tanzanite alone. The oval, look at the depth of color. If you're thinking maybe to buy this as an investment, maybe to resell.
Oh, buying that as an investment and resell. Please tell me that's a buy two to get one scheme. Did they have to mention specifically buy more than one? Or can we just go with the whole sell it thing? Come on. Let's go. Is Marsha actually on the fence too? They have to say buy more than one? All right, let's go back.
...of color. If you're thinking maybe to buy this as an investment, maybe to resell, there is an incredible, incredible opportunity on that oval.
Oh, you're supposed to say on the table, you bastard. Wait, he did ask for SmackDown music. Did he not ask for SmackDown music during that last SmackDown? Didn't he ask for it? How you doing, James? You're just about in time for the halftime joint. And, yeah. Guys, SmackDown music? Last item? Yay or nay? Okay, I guess we can't count it. That's on us. He did, Katron. You promise, Katron? I always feel like you're trying to get squares. Yeah, the previous item when he finally started to lower the price. That first, before the Everybody Dance Now music began, he requested the music. I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty damn sure. I mean, don't let me spend, eternity in hell if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty damn sure. Okay.
Classic minimalist designs. The diamonds on the shoulders are huge, but again,
just a squirrel trying to get a nut. Smooth your butt. Price. Hands in the air. Everybody over here. Everybody over there. Let me see you move.
$2,799 should have been your clearance price. We've gone now to irreplaceable. Not clearance. We've literally gone to irreplaceable.
There is a second literally.
Look at the intent.
Is it? Because, you know what, Katron? If it is CNC Music Factory now, Music Factory night, I want to talk about the things that make you go, Let's talk about the things that make you go, You know? Such as... I can't believe that there was a hit song with the title and like chorus lyric, things that make you go, Even when it came out when I was like 13 years old, I was thinking to myself, this has got to be the stupidest goddamn name for a song I've ever heard. And then Too Legit to Quit came out and that canceled that whole idea. So
if you're looking at this, let me just answer a question that we had. They're the same color of gemstones. The thing is that the round and the trillion, because the Kool-Aid is faceted with microfaceting, it reflects back the light. So you get the depth of color, but you also look
it's
like
the
you have
things
that
inner make
glow
you go
within that gemstone, okay?
Yeah.
That is
things that make you go
and the round.
Things that make you go,
We are getting ready to
like,
go.
How the hell were they in the studio thinking that was a banger?
Let me have one more minute, please.
what an embarrassment of a song.
Round is like seeing a pterodactyl. I mean, you just don't see it. And
a pterodactyl? Wait a minute. Drugs? What about drugs? What's happening? Lola's out? Thanks for the laugh and glad I survived the game. Thanks. Lola, you hit that like button on the way out, right? You're the best, Lola. Thanks for stopping in. Yeah, everybody dance now. James, that's why we bring it up, because the SmackDown music, the music that plays when Tony's about to go final price on an item, is pretty much a bad rip-off sample from Everybody Dance Now. If you haven't heard it before, you'll definitely hear it again, and I'll point it out to you. It's pretty ridiculous. Thanks, Lola.
On sale. Let me tell you a bit about the
Michelle has a story.
How it works here in the U.S. I don't know how it works in Brazil, but
Michelle
I
has a story.
My career in a mid-range.
Of course she does. Of course she does. Josie.
A mall retail store. We literally had the.
That's three literallys. We count Tony and Michelle together. We count it all.
Eternal 50% off.
All right, this
sale.
Is the crucial point of rolling the joint.
There,
please stand
there
by.
50% off signs in the store. There wasn't 2 cents off anything. You were paying full pop. Nothing was on sale. So what happens is they mark it through the roof. And then they bring it down and say, oh, it's on sale. No, it's not. It's not on sale. No one puts this on sale, ever. No one puts this on clearance. We're doing it just because we can't replace it.
Thanks for the explanation. We can't
can
just because. Thank you for that,
carat.
Michelle.
Take a look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Very similar concept, right? Very similar concept. Except that's triple A. Yours is 4A. That's 1.25. Yours is 3 carats.
Anybody? Anybody
I'm
home?
Sure. Because if I leave... And if you see this item on clearance, I don't know when it ends.
I don't think that was 8 seconds. I was counting it kind of in my head, and it felt closer to 6. It is on the board, and it is a huge square, so it's worth a replay. It's worth replaying. Let's go back.
Are you sure? Because if I leave, and if you see this item on clearance, I don't know when it ends, but $2,799 is still a great price.
One Mississippi, mm-hmm. Two Mississippi, three Mississippi.
$2,187 is just a little better.
One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi, four Mississippi, five Mississippi, six Mississippi, seven Mississippi, eight. Yes.
I have to go, guys. I have
to. It was worth the replay. Ladies and gentlemen, just under the wire. Good stuff. Marcia, thanks for, yes. Thanks.
Thank you for nothing, you useless reptile.
Oh, not that kind of thanks. You know the thanks I meant. Boom. Deal of a lifetime or once in a lifetime. Wait a minute. What am I talking about? We've got a little something in our back pocket. It's called a free calculator square. I'm going to go ahead and use it. Ladies and gentlemen, bingo! Hell yeah, baby. Who's worried about the whammy? Now, Marcia, if we put that free square on that whammy before we got to this point, how would you be feeling? How would you be feeling? You'd say, we let that one get away. We let it get away. We played the wrong strategy. What were we thinking? I saved us. I saved the show. Nah, we've earned, you know how hard it is to earn that? No way. That is, like I said, you got to use it like a get out of jail free card. When you get a get out of jail free card of Monopoly, when you go to jail, you don't have to use the card. You can say, you know what? I'm going to pay this time. I want to keep this on standby. I want this in my hip pocket. And we earned it. I mean, I can count on one joint. How many times we've actually gotten the calculator. It's such a rare thing. I'm very happy with this. All right, I'm going to finish my joint and let Tony and Michelle drone on. Maybe we'll get another pricing game in or two. And then after that, I don't know. Maybe I'll do a short stream. Maybe we'll watch some weird off-road stuff. We haven't watched some retro commercials in a while. I can definitely goof on that without too much energy. But for now, Tony and Michelle, maybe another pricing game. In fact, now that we have bingo ready, let's just go ahead and get to the next item. And let's play a pricing game. There we go. Here we go. We got some mating jewelry. Right here and now. $5,999 for a pair of what looks like avatar earrings. I don't know. These look like some kind of James Cameron earrings or something. Amanda's in with the first bid. How you doing, Jacob? So now we got James and Jacob. Guys, if you're not familiar, we do pricing games. When they show us a new item and give us the starting price, our job is to guess the final price. And please keep in mind, when you see bids already listed, to keep your price within a certain buffer to not, box someone in by like 10 bucks. You know, have a little decorum, everyone. I don't need to be the adult in the room, do I? You guys know what I'm talking about. You're like, Steve, well, what is it? Is it a $50 spread, $100 spread? Well, it increases the bigger the price is, you know? We just got to kind of, be cool about it. All right, it looks like we got a lot of bids in here. $6,000. I'm going to say nobody picked it. Nobody picked a classic 999 price. All right, I'll go. I'll go with that. I like a classic 999. It's like it's under $1,000. We're giving this to you for under $1,000 by one penny, but it's technically under $1,000. It's a three-digit number piece of jewelry, not a four-digit number. Okay.
Talking.
Let's
now
go.
We are right up my alley. We have cushion cut.
Cushion cut
earrings in platinum.
It's getting to the point now, by the way, where I might just make the phrase cushion cut a square. And I feel like we hear it 40 to 50% of every time they do.
10
every carats, time they work.
A carat 5 each, 6 by 6 millimeter.
The old cushion cut.
Mamma mia, look at this.
That's amore.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, SmackDown Music.
Hey! Okay, so we did mark it off already, but now we know that we are, legit. Okay. All right, so this is the SmackDown music for those that were asking. Just close your eyes and think of everybody dance now,
look
okay?
At this.
Starting
thank you, ladies and gentlemen,
right
SmackDown music.
Now. Everybody dance now.
Go.
Oh.
Minutes, please.
Where are we at?
Okay.
What do we got?
Also.
Where the hell are we? We're going down to 20. That. Whoa. How? $11.99. Whoa.
No less.
Is this the final?
Anyway,
I'm 200
no
off.
$800 to add.
I might be. Oh, wait. Oh, $12.99. Amanda, 100 off.
I don't know.
If that's the final, Amanda has it.
A carat five each. You have.
I'm second closest, hoping for one more drop.
Set in.
I don't think I'm going to get it.
Of 950 platinum. So each earring is a gram of platinum. Have a look at this in the ear. These are absolutely beautiful.
Bends with a major
prediction. You don't have to worry
prediction.
About them going anywhere. Because that screw back.
Ben showing her shop
that does not
LC expertise.
Take it off.
SmackDown music, please.
Oh, snap. Ben's is right. We're going down again. Tony pounded the table, by the way. In case anybody was curious what the most, rarest thing ever in the history of anything ever, it's pounding the table.
SmackDown music, please. Ladies and gentlemen, you know what? I'm here to clear items. I'm here to do what nobody else.
Come on, Marcia. I know, but I mean, God, how many times has it happened since you said how rare it was? How many times? Like half the time? I won't mention it anymore. Unless, like, it's months from now, like, as a retro joke. But as a contemporary joke, I'm retiring it, okay?
What can do in terms of pricing.
I promise.
Thank you very much. Congratulations. 987 go.
Oh, 987.
As the very famous American
I bid 999, baby.
If this doesn't
I bid 999, baby. Yeah.
You are a genius.
You don't buy the loose stones for that price. You don't buy the loose stones for that price.
I might need a screenshot. I really haven't had anything to take a screenshot of yet.
For that price.
Yeah, that's the one. All right. I'm just glad her thumb isn't pointing up, or else this would look a little more sinister. You know what I mean? But for this, I think we're okay. Where's my snipping tool? Why aren't you showing him my snipping tool? Recent. What is this? I'm trying to type in snipping tool. Look for it. Where are you? Stop messing with me. Don't mess with me. I'm on my like seventh hour of live streaming in one day. Okay? Don't mess with me. You don't want to mess with this. Things that make you go That is bad taste. Okay. Mahone. Mahone head point. I don't know. I got other places to go, but I already made the joke. Is that the new snipping tool? I don't know.
Price.
That's a thinker.
Is that a new update?
3 minutes. That is a very wise American philosopher.
Who's that? Dave Barry?
Charming. So I hear. I've never met her.
All right, look at this
that.
Set.
Look at my ear.
Look at this set.
You tell me.
Good evening, Thomas.
If you're passing up on this, you have willpower.
And don't you worry, sir. The
because
grieving over
well
losing in
a
horrible fashion
quad A
has passed.
Tonight. If you cut that price in half,
Yogi Berra said it best. It ain't over till it's over. I'm not
so
expecting us to win this series.
Let's throw in a penny.
But I ain't done yet.
That is $400.
Hey, Danielle.
And $95 a stone.
Thomas, it took you that long to get that in? Come on.
Included.
I'm already way ahead of you, buddy. Signed, sealed, delivered.
That does not include.
You're at work, night shift, starting from the beginning to enjoy.
Does not include.
While you do some chatting.
The ridiculously low appraisal.
Yeah, Danielle, got a couple
is,
of new people in tonight. A couple of new subs as
so
well. And also
times under
some new subs from doing the sports streaming, so.
And if you buy the earring
you know,
on the left,
nose
we'll
to the grindstone,
the
right?
On the right at no additional charge. And there's
somehow I've turned running a
we're
YouTube channel into something as difficult as ice
oh,
road
wait,
truckers or Alaskan snow crab
Constance,
crabbing.
Teresa, good job.
I got a deadly job.
Look at this. Mike, how many of these do we have? Oh, come on.
Hey,
look
Maria.
At this. Guys.
Would
get
you look at this room?
Your unbridled orneriness, just so you can tell people you did. Look at that. When they say, that is not a Tanzanite, you'll say, it's not. Okay, well, I give up. What is it then?
Maria, I have indeed had a long day, and I got a feeling once I light up this joint, I might pass out on camera. So you guys have that going for you. If you have Steve passes out during his live stream on your bingo card,
Montauk.
I think
Ooh.
You're in good luck tonight. I think you're in good shape.
Okay, Alice, I know someone that lives in Montauk. Is that the same Montauk on Long Island?
That's doxing. That's doxing. Yes, Marcia. And have I not proven that they'll do this? Once again, trust in Steve. Trust in Steve, and ye shall not perish. Michelle just completely doxed a customer.
Alice, come on. Montauk. Oh, ooh. Okay, Alice. I know someone that lives in Montauk. Is that the same Montauk on Long Island that Showtime did that movie about? Love it.
What Showtime movie? Was it an episode of Red Shoe Diaries? What the hell are you talking about? All right. We got a dox.
Love Montauk. Beautiful. Welcome. Okay.
By the way, are you on 3rd Avenue or 4th?
Actually, it's a series. It's called The Affair. Have y'all ever seen? Not that I condone them, but it is a really good series. Have a look at that.
Michelle, I'm going to take my Netflix advice from myself.
Good. Thank you very much. You're getting too...
Tony interrupting Michelle's TV suggestions. Where's my... Speaking of a snipping tool... Cut the umbilical cord and ladies and gentlemen, joint lighting music, please. I don't have the same kind of buzzer, but. Oh, I gotta go get something. I'll be right back. Hang in there.
Two gemstones perfectly matched over 1 carat each. Let's be honest here. Mm-hmm. We don't do the gemstones for that price. But anyway, it is what it is. Thank you. We're moving.
Wow. Yowza, that's pretty. You know what? If you bought 2 grams of platinum in just a pendant or just a band, you would be talking about a lot of
over
money.
And over. La 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 la.
We've got Jay Washington or
Crimson and Clover. Over and over.
So you can drive around and let people see your earrings.
What the hell? Drive around and let people see your earrings? What? Where do you plan on doing that? In a neighborhood where if they're nice, they'd probably carjack you? Or in a neighborhood where people are rich and wouldn't give a shit about what earrings you're wearing? Where are you driving around impressing people with your earrings? Please, describe the scenario to me. What the
earrings,
fuck are you talking about?
They have holes in their ear. Look at that. They went to town on that. Okay, now, we have a pendant in yellow. We don't get a lot in yellow. This is 14 karat gold in oval. Also, it's not loaded yet.
We on to a new item? Folks, if you're within earshot, run to your keyboard. We have a new item coming.
Your mic, Mike.
I'm on a one-game winning streak. Who dare challenge me?
Mr. Producer, what do you have as your final price?
$44.99. Wasn't this the same starting price as the last one? All right, I'm going to go a little bit different. I don't know. Folks, I'll give you a few seconds to get your bid in. Crimson and clover, over and over. Crimson and clover, over and over. Now the psychedelic part. Crimson and clover. Crimson and clover. I mean, it's right on the money. Okay, we got our bids. Let's see what we got.
Okay, it's a carat 23.
Smackdown music, one price, one drum.
Okay.
$499 go.
Whoa, that's damn near 10% the price, but Melinda, if we are on the final price, Melinda with a dead-on bid. Melinda, if we were on the prices right now, you'd be coming up from contestants row and reaching your hand into my pocket to pull out a nice fresh Benjamin. Well done. Let's make sure this sticks. Jacob, you're a little late on the bid.
What you didn't hear is, producer, what's your final price?
All right, well, don't count your chickens yet. We got to, we can't, we never know. We never quite know when they'll do something, you know,
different price.
Hypocritical or something.
I'm not going to say it was lower. I'm just not going to say anything. All right. There's, I'm just catching.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There is some kind of issue on the set, some kind of mic trouble or something. I need to go back and listen to this.
I'm not going to say it was lower. I'm just not going to say anything. All right.
Right there. What is that? It's like a page ripping or something.
I'm just not going to say anything. All right. There's,
it's super loud. I mean, it's louder than their own speech. I have to count that. as a production issue of some sort. I mean, look, we already got bingo, so it's not like I'm trying to cheat my way to the promised land. We're already in the promised land. We're playing with house money. If anything, I'm going to just get the hell out of here and watch some commercials. In fact, that sounds very appealing.
Catching y'all up.
I'm just trying to get some pricing games in here. Because I know you guys like the pricing games. So I'm not going to let Tony waste my time. I'm going to go ahead and see what happens here. Maybe we'll get one more game in. Instead of sitting here watching this dumb thing being sold like one every 5 minutes. Oh, wait a minute. No, this is still the same thing. It looks like they only had about 10 of them. Wait. How is the left count going up? What? Why is the left count? They changed from like how many they had or how many they sold to how many they got left. And so why would the left count be going up?
Or six left.
All right, now it's at five, but wait, what happens after this?
People didn't confirm.
Doesn't it go back up here?
My people
all right, there. It goes from four to seven.
Seven left. Why?
Seven left.
Did not confirm.
Oh, there was.
5 minutes knows. When I say I'm going to buy something, I buy something. My mail carrier has to wear a back brace. Seven left. Why? Because people did not confirm.
Oh, my God. Did you hear what she just said? When I buy something, I buy it. She's basically chastising people who are calling on the phone, but not, like, locking in their order. Like, lady, maybe some people want to think about it. It's $500. You know, that's not play money for everybody, you know? Maybe they're hesitating. Maybe they want to make sure they can, you know, get it resized or some shit. I don't know. Maybe they got some questions. I don't know. But don't call people out for not confirming. It's your fault for dropping the number of items that are left, and you keep doing this. You keep jumping the gun, saying something's out the door, and then retracting it. Like, I can see you making that mistake once and then saying, okay, now on, do not show an item having been sold until it's been confirmed. New decree. But no, they won't do it. So I don't know if they intentionally want, but I don't see what the benefit is of these people who are unconfirmed and they have to retract. It doesn't seem to, it's not like creating a panic or a scarcity or whatever, like some of these other little tricks up their sleeve. This just seems like incompetence. Just don't confirm it.
Tony, this is probably
okay,
one of the
gentlemen,
best
thank
deals
you.
I have seen on tape
We're
tonight.
Leaving.
All right, keep.
We're leaving. I'm sick of this. Three people are on the phone telling me they'd buy it. Now they're not buying it. I'm mad. We're leaving. That's how Tony sounds, leaving like a TGI Fridays, like when they don't refill his iced tea fast enough. He just gets up from the table. Ladies and gentlemen, we're leaving. I've had enough of this. I mean,
calling in on that or go to the website or what have you. But, okay,
Jesus.
Now we are going to lightning round.
Lightning round? Okay. See, this is probably going to be where we can't even do a pricing game because they're just going to drop it every 15 seconds. So I'm going to ride out the clock. Well, I'll give you folks two choices. Do you want Steve to maybe take a half hour off and call it a day? Or would you rather watch some commercials and round out the hour? I'm done with Tony and Michelle. And if you have any specific commercials, like an era or a theme, you can throw it out there. But I'll go back to the 70s here. We'd rather watch Steve have a meltdown while watching commercials. Okay, well, that can happen. That could happen. 70s. I just type in 70s. A little more info, Steve. Need the info. Okay. In 4K. Whoa. 4K. Holy cow. An hour's worth. You know what? I'm going to save that one for maybe a night where we spend a full hour doing this. That goes to the watch later. Let me look for something a little farther down. Hour of vintage. Various late 70s, early 80s. Relaxing 80s commercials. I don't know why, K-Tron. Oh my God, I want the... Dude, look at this. What a great thumbnail. The Banquet Man Pleaser. I know about Hungry Man. The Swanson Hungry Man dinner. But I have never seen... anything called the man pleaser. We are definitely going in. Let's go. Are you kidding me? Periscope stock footage. Periscope films. What's the full name of the channel? Periscope Film is the YouTube channel. Big fan, Periscope. Thank you for allowing me to embrace fair use and provide some commentary for this particular set of historic commercials. You know, this is historic stuff. By the way, somebody's doing a live stream talking about the Orioles game. And there's me with my... talk about clickbait. Got Katy Perry basically going full gyno. That's, all right, let's get into this. What do we got?
The 675-watt Amana radar range microwave.
Oh, my God. I can see the radiation coming off of it already. You're in Chernobyl. You are in ground zero right now, lady. Get out. Get out. Those early microwaves. Don't even... No, it's not... It looks like a TV. You'd think it was a TV. Nah. This is... This thing has its own Geiger counter built in.
Microwave oven has quality features. Two timers, stainless steel interior, glass oven tray that catches spills and juices.
I love the drop down tray, like trying to emulate like an actual oven. Like that, this is how you would know better than me, Marcia. I don't recognize her.
And the Amana Cookmatic Power.
Not related to Alan Hale, I would hope, right? There's no way Alan Hale had a hottie wife.
Shit. Let's you select the cooking speed you need. High speed, roast, medium and low. Great for gourmet.
Look at these settings.
Select
Holy
the cooking
cow.
Speed you need. High speed.
Like yeah. How many half lives do you want this cooked at?
Roast, medium and low. Great for gourmet recipes. Simmer and warm. That's quality. The Amana radar range with Cookmatic Power Shift.
Oh, she's definitely got a raspy... She's got a good speaking voice, yeah. If it doesn't say Amanda, it's not a road range, road ranger. Or, I'm sorry, Amana? How the hell are you supposed to say this? Why are they showing us a tiny picture on the screen? Why are they filling up the screen with their ad? Is it Amana or Amana? Is it man or mon? Amana? What an awful name for a product. No wonder I never heard of it.
This is the new man pleaser dinner from...
Whoa, here it comes. Watch out, boy. It'll fill you up. Whoa, here it comes. It's the man pleaser.
Banquet. The big one. For guys with extra big appetites. Like mine.
And the new man pleaser dinners come in four varieties. Fried chicken, Salisbury...
Here's the wife who has refused to cook anymore.
And the new man-pleaser dinners come in four varieties. Fried chicken, Salisbury steak, meatloaf, and turkey.
Oh, Marcia, that is a very good fact to know. That is quite the interesting fact. Maybe I've had that brand of something I just never picked up on. I don't know. It's new to me, okay? I'm doing a reacting to what I'm familiar with. Look at the mascot here. We got like a Paul Bunyan sort of, a couple of burly men sawing a tree down, just depleting a forest. No wonder they're so hungry. What do we got here? Wait a minute. If this is potatoes, I guess that's like a corn and pea medley. I think I'm seeing the edge of maybe like a strawberry, like a cobbler thing or something. Something reddish. And then I guess I got what, like turkey slices with some gravy and stuffing. Turkey dinner.
Just heat and serve.
I'm pretty sure that's, I mean, the color grade is awful in these commercials from this era. They can never make food look right. But I'm pretty sure that's peas and carrots.
And you've got a complete meal.
You got to have the vegetables in there.
So next time you're long on appetite.
And you're short on...
I couldn't read it.
Time.
I tried to read it.
Just pick up the new man-pleaser dinner from Banquet.
It's the big meal.
At a little price.
All right, we get it.
Hello?
Sandy, please cook dinner.
I know, Danielle. Can you believe it? The calculator helped us get bingo today. And we avoided the whammy. We didn't even have to use it on the whammy. It really was a solid game of bingo tonight, I have to say, especially considering I'm working on like 20% battery life as a person right now.
Mom,
take the ham out and put it in our Amana Touch Magic.
No. Do not cook an entire ham in the microwave, please. Not in a 1974 microwave, no.
Okay.
Do not do that.
Touch 10 minutes to frost
time. No, no, no.
25 minutes cooking time and start.
No.
Simple.
When it beeps and shows...
Back away from the machine.
...the time of day, slide the cookmatic to...
Back away from the machine.
Warm. Start for 10 minutes.
Today, a great cook...
A giant ham cooked fully in a 1974 microwave. Ma, this is going to taste just like Grandma used to make. Wait till you get a load of this.
Tonight, your homework.
Oh, Mom. I love this time code and everything. This really is like archive footage. I really do feel like I'm doing historic commentary. This is good stuff.
Amanda announces it's 3 to...
All right. I take it back. Is it gonna be all this? I need more than this lady and all this kitchen shit. I need a little variety here.
Hi,
I see. Banquet. I didn't read this title enough. Banquet TV Dinners, Seiko Watches, Amex TV, Purina. Okay, so I guess there's a few. So let's get past the frickin' microwave. Yeah, we got the man pleaser out of the way. As I often like to say, we're playing with house money at this point. Okay, now we've got some kind of montage of wives planning to kill their husbands. So let's take a look at it. So let's see what this is.
Mother's mother had to use bleach to get things white. And your mother's mother had to use bleach.
Different ways to kill your spouse with bleach.
And your mother used bleach. But now you don't have to if you don't want to. Introducing.
Did you see that chloroform bottle this bleach is in? Did it really come in like old school like chemistry class bottles like this?
Want to. Introducing Boratine Plus, the bleach substitute. Because you
just 2 glasses a day and a sensible dinner.
Your laundry isn't like your great-grandmother's. You have more colors to keep alive and fabric she never even heard of. Boratine Plus.
Boratine. The bleach substitute. So it's powdered bleach that isn't, I guess it's some sort of synthetic bleach. Hell if I know. I mean, maybe I'm no spring chicken, but last I checked, bleach still comes in that classic liquid, don't smell it too closely form. Right?
You don't have to bleach if you don't want to.
This is probably made out of, like, asbestos chips. I don't know what this... There's probably something crazy unsafe in here.
Have
have you noticed, but a lot of your...
Whoa, good Lord. This date escalated in a hurry. Jesus. Can I get to know you a little bit?
Have you God noticed damn. A lot of your...
I mean, right out of the park. Good on this guy, huh? That date was a success. What's going on, Rhino? Hey, you're just in time for a trip down retro commercial lane. And yeah, we're just basically watching your basic porn commercial, you know. Middle-aged lady taking her dress off. You know, like you do.
Your clothes are wearing these days? Labels.
They're married. I would hope so. I would hope that at this point of American history, we weren't showing commercials of like two people just being what do they call it? Hedonistic. just going to town. Oh, yeah, what do we got here?
Bleach is out. What's in?
Donut bleach.
The bleach substitute. It comes on strong enough to whiten white things, strong enough to work on stains.
So wait a minute. They think they got a workaround. Oh, yes, we got the bingo pool. Thanks for getting in here. And Rhino, did I say hello? It's good to see you, Rhino. Are you done streaming for the day, my friend? A long Sunday of streaming your butt off? Boy, I tell you what. You give me a little extra motivation, Rhino. You're putting in some serious hours. I just put in the longest amount of streaming in one day in my young YouTuber career, and I am spent. I mean, it doesn't help that this all began at 3 a.m. my time. You know, if I started at 9 a.m. and did it to like 4 in the afternoon, I think I'd be okay, but whew, good Lord. All right.
But never too strong for colors or permanent press. Boratine Plus. The bleach substitute. Because your laundry's...
All right. Let's put the shirt on correctly. I love hearing those audio pops. Is she trying to find a sledgehammer? Why don't you call her name?
Most families open the refrigerator many...
This will be my recipe.
So Anna has a refrigerator on top with the freezer on the bottom. And features like...
I don't like how they... she just sort of, you know, nonchalantly flings these doors open. You know, you got to be careful with that. Wait a minute. Let me get a look in here. Hold on. I'm done with this lady, but I want to... If we're going to get a look under the hood, I'm in.
The outside.
Freezer on the bottom?
And the big Friofrost freezer.
Don't they understand that cold things are on top? There's a reason why snow is on top of a mountain, not at the bottom. What are they doing?
Even an ice maker you can add now or later, Amanda.
The hell are you doing, lady? Get out of here. Enough with these Amanda products.
Baking soda deodorant.
Baking soda deodorant.
All these smelly men having a moment.
Baking soda deodorant?
That's right, baking soda. Nature's great deodorant in new Arm & Hammer underarm deodorant. The more natural way to stay fresh and clean smelling. And with cornstarch to help...
That doesn't look natural at all. That looks like how the ozone layer started to deplete.
Keep you neat and dry. Even feels nice and dry going on.
Baking soda deodorant.
Oh my God, it's Stephen Colbert. Before he had glasses, I guess. It's good to see he had some early work.
Nature's great deodorant.
When occasional minor tension keeps...
Oh, wait a minute, is this a horror film? Wait. The Exorcist came out around this time with all these commercials. I don't know. This could get ugly.
You awake. Which sleeping aid should you take?
Wait, is her nightgown on backwards? Or is this just the worst nightgown in the history of nightgowns?
Which sleeping aid should you take?
I guess it's just the worst nightgown. Okay.
Look, Of the three leading sleeping aids, only Sleepy's is formulated solely to relieve
sleeping
the mind tension
aids
that can keep you awake. Sleepy's combines a tension easer with a sleep helper to...
Hey, you want to get to sleep? Stream for 7 hours straight or something.
Create one of the most effective products you
You'll
can find
right
to
sleep.
To relax so you can get to sleep. Sleepy's, take only as directed. Sleep.
God, look at that. God, I love the design. I love the design. Just the name and then the catchphrase. Just two colors, a stripe. That's it. This looks like something out of Repo Man. I love product designs like this.
Sleepy's, the one to take when minor tension keeps you awake.
Minor tension? That's me all day, every day. Apparently, I need to buy a whole lot of that stuff. Wait, is this horse gonna... Is this Artex? Please, Artex, don't. Don't let the swamp of sadness take you, Artex. Please. Oh, okay.
Let's go. Wow, do I have a headache.
Here, take something strong.
What could possibly be giving you a headache other than super loud carnival music that's super repetitive and obnoxious and a bunch of screaming kids? What in the world could possibly be giving you a headache in this situation?
Adult strength Anacin.
Aren't they all for adults?
Yes, but while ordinary aspirin, buffered aspirin, and Anacin start with the same amount of pain reliever, adult strength Anacin...
Man, this was at the height of the aspirin wars. This is at the height of... Like, who is it? Is it Bayer? Is it Anacin? Who's going to win this war?
Anacin adds 23% more. Then Anacin adds an extra ingredient not found in the others.
Headache gone?
Like that.
Oh my Anacin. God, that is the worst cotton candy. Ingredient not found. This looks like a Q-tip.
Headache gone?
What in the world? It's pure white. Who has ever had pure white cotton candy? And I swear, Marcia, if you tell me you have, I'm jumping off the fifth floor balcony. If you tell me you've had pure white cotton candy, this ain't pink. I'm sorry. It's as white as the pill that we're transferring out of. You can match it up, the whiteness. If it's supposed to be pink, they've done a terrible job. Oh, you've only had pink.
Like that.
I mean, I've had like blue. I've probably had pink, blue. I might have had red. I might have had fucking every color in the rainbow, but not white.
And Anacin didn't upset my stomach.
Adult strength Anacin.
Oh, God, not again. Okay, let's get the hell out of here. We get it, dude. Oh, my God, it's another one. What a weird collection. This must be like... I mean, this truly is like some kind of archived commercial footage. What is this pipeline thing?
Construction of Alaska's natural beauty is revealed...
Oh, God, the original construction of the Alaskan pipeline. My God. This thing is still a source of much debate and frustration for a lot of people. Half a century later. Warning, warning. Okay, what the hell am I looking at here? What kind of mascot Schoolhouse Rock looking shit is this?
A prominent television executive offers a harsh warning to his colleagues this week in TV Guide.
What? What? That was the whole thing? That was the whole thing. What the hell did I just see?
A prominent television executive offers a harsh warning to his colleagues this week in TV Guide.
And that's that. Wow, let me run out and get a copy. My God, I... The work. Oh, no, go away. Okay, this is later 70s. Can you see the difference? You can definitely see the difference between like 1973, 74 versus like 77, 78. And the reason why I know the difference is because this is right when I was born. I know exactly what was happening.
Electric bill up to $100 a year.
She's swinging the doors open again.
Keeps the electric bills down because the 3-inch foam insulation is thicker than it's ever been used.
Holy shit.
Refrigerator. It has the amount of
I've had apartments with walls not that thick.
Pressure longer because super cold air.
Okay, we've seen enough of it. God, all right, enough. Oh, this must be the Seiko ads. They're probably not that interesting.
The most accurate kind of watch used to sound like this. Then, like this tuning fork.
That
now it sounds
watches
like
used to make a noise like that? Who would
the
wear
Seiko
it?
Seiko quartz gives you accuracy you can see as well as hear. As the second hand moves in precise 1-second intervals. It's the watch that's changing the world's standard of accuracy. Seiko Quartz.
The world's standard of accuracy. Oh boy. Wait, is this gonna be the man pleaser? We got a couple of burly men sawing a tree down. Do we get a second man pleaser ad with a little extra something going on here? I love how their idea of like I love their idea of selling like what a man is as a guy that chops down trees.
It's a big job. A long day. And banquet.
I need a man pleaser
to satisfy appetites.
The man. We need them. Oh my God. And it cuts right into the thing. Oh, wow. Look at that. Wow. Can we? That is TV magic, folks.
Meal to satisfy appetites.
Look at that. Boom. That is a live shot. Look at this transition. Look at that. So you have to think they shot the commercial and then the illustrator just pretty much did like a trace job. There's just no way they recreated this perfectly. It is right on. I don't know.
Four different.
Go back to the edit. I'm right on the edit.
New meal to satisfy appetites.
I'm all over the edit. This is it. There's the. That's how seamless it is. It's a really nice job.
Pleaser. Four different dinners. Turkey,
Oh, here they come.
And fried chicken. Simply heat and serve and you've got a complete man-sized dinner.
Look at the wife coming in and serving us up like, are you proud of me, honey? I was able to do it. A shake and bake. And I helped.
You know will please your man. Look for the new man pleaser.
Who and the other thing is like the only reason you're eating this, even if you're like married and like nobody wants to cook, you better be sitting over in the family room watching the Honeymooners or some shit. Or I guess at this point, All in the Family or Mary Tyler Moore. I don't know. Who wants to sit at the dinner table eating out of a tray like this? Take your ass on over the TV.
Dinners from banquet. In the frozen food section of your supermarket.
What are you going to have stimulating conversation over this garbage you're eating?
Seiko announces the world's first digital quartz liquid crystal chronograph. It gives the time, the date, and with a push of a button.
Holy shit, look at these features.
It records lap times and 1-2 finishes.
Lap times? Whoa, this is how Michael Phelps won all those medals.
In tenths of seconds. The time of day, kept in electronic memory, reappears when you push the button again.
Whoa!
The Seiko Liquid Crystal Chronograph. Only one of Seiko's superb digital quartz watches.
Someday all watches will be made this way. Actually, someday all phones will be made that way times a trillion. You get the lap feature. Porn in 4K. And, you can also, trade stocks. And, message your drug dealer. You can do whatever, you can do everything. What do we got? The Bastard. Okay. All right, Steve. Think on your feet. Who's this about? Let's see. Could it be 1970-something? God. Is this the first Trump novel? Did he try his hand at books early on?
The Bastard.
Is this pre-Art of the Deal?
The Rebels, the Seekers, the Furies, the Titans. The thrilling
All
saga
right.
of a family's passion, strife, and adventure through 200 years of America's history is now available in this beautifully bound five-volume paperback boxed set. The John Jakes by...
John Jakes. I am not a... I mean, The Seekers, is that an adaptation of the movie by the same name?
Centennial series, which has soared on bestseller lists throughout the country, is the gift on top of everyone's list this year. The John Jakes Bicentennial.
Have any of these been adapted into movies that I might have seen? I don't know these books. I don't know the author.
Everywhere.
I stink.
His TV is.
What is this? Oh, is this going to be like pirating TV? Why are they showing like a prison wall while a guy sits and watches TV? This has got to be stealing cable or one of those early. Something kind of things. Let's
School
see.
For crime. Find out what criminals learn from the screen despite what experts say. This week in TV Guide.
Oh, it's just another bizarre illustration while selling it. What was with TV Guide's ad campaign? Very weird. They hired an illustrator to just draw a single image of something. That last one with the like cash register robot thing or whatever.
Learn from the screen despite what experts
Very strange.
Say. This week in TV Guide.
Very strange.
Still.
All right, we're coming up on the midnight hour here pretty soon. I'll be wrapping it up somewhere around midnight. It might be a few minutes over. Might be soon as this commercial's. I don't know. But it's going to be soon. Just getting everybody prepared.
Lugging your big old umbrella.
Uh-oh.
Or struggling with a little one. Now there's Totes, the revolutionary compact
Totes.
Umbrella that opens instantly.
Oh, is this... This is the origin of, you know, the classic sort of compact umbrella that you can, like, fit in your pocket. Man, they're nice in theory, but anything over 15 miles an hour wind-wise, forget about it. You're toast with this Totes.
Big enough for two. The Totes umbrella is completely windproof, made to last.
Windproof my ass. Windproof my ass. Show us. Show us some, give us a demo of this thing in the wind.
Disappears in a pocket or briefcase. Give him Totes, $14.95 with handsome case.
Yeah, but does it come with the porcelain puppy thing? What about that? All right. Ellen Green Cooking School.
Handling raw fish, here's a hint. Rub your hands with salt, and that way the fish won't slip. And here's another hint. Real flavor deserves real baggies. With the alligator, there's no better way to wrap fresh food. Baggies hug poo tight.
There's no better way to suffocate a loved one.
Then seal tight right down next to the food. Baggies is the one I use.
Right! Real flavor deserves real baggies.
Oh, gee, I wonder why that mascot never took off. Why isn't that dude as big as, like, Tony the Tiger?
I say that noontime is eat with a spoon time. Don't need a fork or knife. My basic rule for kids home from school is
I can't believe it. Somebody from Stairway to Stardom got a commercial.
When the kids come home for lunch, they have a big appetite, but only a little time. So I sit them down to sandwiches and Campbell's vegetable soup, the alphabet soup. Campbell's helps me warm them up and fill them up fast.
Give me the Campbell life!
Ah, shit.
Excuse me, what will you feed your horse?
Horse?
Exploited pet. Exploited pets.
Purina horse chow. And your goat?
Purina goat chow?
Purina also makes foods
like
veal chow.
Oh, God, it's Black Phillip. Black Phillip's in the kitchen. Get out.
Hey, but I want to feed my dog.
Feed him the food made by the people who know animals.
Purina dog chow.
We pour everything we know about animals into every bag.
Bruno, that's a lot of experience you're eating.
And now your dog can experience a great new taste, new beef, bacon, and cheese flavor.
Wilbur. All right, what are we watching?
Snacking's a great American pastime. What if nutrition is lacking in your...
Who has a phone on the stairs?
Family snacking. Treat them to a high...
I guess everybody had long cords back then, so you can go anywhere. What is this? Cheese kisses? What? Are these like Hershey kisses, but made of cheese instead of chocolate? What the hell is this?
Protein snack, Borden cheese kisses, instead of sweets and stuff. Individually wrapped.
Instead of sweets, just pound your stomach with cheese. Cheese kisses. Ew. Look at this kid stuffing himself with cheese. Like a little mouse.
Protein-rich cheese kisses are bite-sized nuggets of delicious pasteurized processed cheese spread. So if...
Bite-sized... Wait, I gotta hear that whole thing. I heard processed spread... Not cheese, cheese spread. I mean, they had to get through a whole...
Cheese kisses instead of sweets and stuff. Individually wrapped protein-rich cheese kisses are bite-sized nuggets of delicious pasteurized processed cheese spread.
Bite-sized nuggets of delicious, processed, pasteurized cheese spread. Jesus Christ. Somebody shorten the... You know, they've got this new brand of potato chip, or it comes like in a tennis ball can, and the chips are all uniformly shaped and they can be stacked. They're called Pringles. See how easy that was to explain? That was less...
So if nutrition is lacking in your family snacking, treat them to...
Nutrition? Nutrition?
Cheese kisses, a high-protein snack, instead of sweets and stuff.
What? High protein. Not like some trail mix, like a bag of peanuts or something. Cheese. Cheese, just known for that high protein count, I guess. I don't know. I thought it was more of like a calcium sort of place to go. Oh, it's the Palmolive lady, right? Hey, I guess we're going to wrap up with the Palmolive lady. You know, it softens hands while you do the dishes. That's what I've heard. Like, you don't need to go to a manicurist because you can just wash the dishes to get the same effect.
You expect me to do both these today?
Aren't they awful, man?
Oh, don't miss a trick on these beauties. Start with palm olive dishwashing liquid. You know, it softens your hands while you do the dishes.
I didn't know that. Madge, you're blowing my mind. Wait, run that back. What does it do?
You expect me to do both these today?
Aren't they awful, man?
Oh, don't miss a trick on these beauties. Start with palm olive dishwashing liquid. You know, it softens your hands while you do the dishes.
I know. I didn't know that.
Dishwashing liquid? It's palm olive. Mild?
Oh, more than just mild. Makes a kitchen full of suds. And
didn't she basically make this exact commercial pretty much like a new one every year for like 20 years? It's the same shit. Somebody sits at her little manicurist table. She grabs her hand, sticks it in the green goop. And says the same goddamn thing. I mean, talk about a gig. You know, watching baseball lately and seeing some of the broadcasts with commercials, I'm watching some American commercials. You know, it's been years since I've been watching, you know, U.S. commercials for the most part. I'm unfortunately seeing a whole lot of Danny DeVito in these Jersey Mike subs ads. And like, Danny, I love you, buddy, but do you need the money this bad? But anyway, I saw one with the progressive insurance lady, you know? I can't remember the name, but she's got the red hair and like the big thing in her hair and always wearing the dumb apron and the blue eyes and all that. Yeah, Flo. Flo's still kicking it. Is it safe to say Flo is this generation's Madge? I mean, what a run. I saw her in this ad. I hadn't seen her in an ad in probably 8 years at least. And, you know, she ain't looking like she used to. You know, I guess if you see the ads gradually, maybe it's, you know, you don't notice. But take an 8 year break.
And remember, Palmolive, it softens your hands while you do the dishes.
All right. Well, remember. Oh, wait, it's 2 weeks
Madge,
later.
Palmolive super, I'll never forget you.
And even this part is the same. They come back 2 weeks later, and they're like, Madge, you were right, my hands. You wouldn't believe it. I can't find enough dishes to wash. I'm just addicted to washing dishes.
Really? Do you know your appointment was last week?
Well, she does go back to before, like high-end, high-def TV. Maybe the better, the higher definition screens and stuff. I'm just seeing a little more of Flow. I don't know. All right, I gotta wrap it up. Hey, but we're on Pleasant Street. How can I leave now?
Your street turns into Hay Fever Street. Be ready with Driss.
That might be the least clever thing ever. This was an ad man. I say ad man, not trying to be sexist. Just that was sort of the lingo of the day. But you mean to tell me an ad man sat in a room like Don Draper and came up with this gem of a commercial idea? Yeah, but remember, Mad Men dips into the 70s and there's a bit of a like female influence starting to get in there. It's Mary Tyler Moore time, baby. There's a little bit of women power getting in there. It's still a man, but yeah, the lingo was still definitely an ad man, right? This is an awful idea. Pleasant Street turns into Hay Fever Street. Isn't Street. That clever?
Turns into Hay Fever Street.
That is the stupidest idea.
Ready with Dristan tablets. Compare leading allergy products. Only Dristan combines.
All right, guys, I want you to close your eyes. Picture this. There's a lady walking down. It's a beautiful suburban neighborhood, and it's a crystal clear day. The leaves are rustling, and you see a sign, and it says Pleasant Street, and you think it's utopia. But then she sneezes. And we cut to a new version of the sign, and it says Hay Fever Street. Do you get it? Folks, are you with me? Okay, that'll be $35,000 for that idea. Thank you. Have a nice day. All right. I'm getting out of here. Here's tonight's winning bingo card. Fantastic. The calculator coming into effect. Thank you, calculator. Thank you so much. And thanks to everybody in chat. If you don't mind, hang around for a minute longer, maybe 90 seconds. I don't frickin' know. But I'm doing the outro here. I'm doing my thing. Where's the thing? All right, folks. Thank you to Marsha and Poole and Amanda and Melinda and Katron and Rhino stopping in. There's going to be a lot of names I'm going to not have because, it doesn't go back. There's a lot of activity tonight. I enjoyed the turnout, especially considering the fact that I am working on fumes here, folks. I think my eyes are half closed right now. Right. Here's what you can do if you're watching later, if you don't mind. If you got to this point of the program, I'm going to assume maybe you enjoyed it. I hope you did. If so, you can help out the channel by hitting that little thumbs up thing right below the screen you're looking at, right? You can also subscribe, join the family, be here for the live experience. I'd like to be here for the live experience. I'd like to be more alive for the next show. Oh, by the way, program note, tomorrow's stream will be on, but the following night, that would be the Tuesday night stream, will be canceled for sure. There is no Tuesday night stream. Program note, sorry for the late news on that. Getting back to the outro spiel, once you do subscribe, and I would advise you to, because you want to be here for the live experience, go ahead and hit the notification bell, and then you'll get the little alert and let you know when the stream is on. You come in, you join the chat, you play some games, you crack some jokes. You'll love it. You'll never regret it, okay? Leave a comment down below if you don't mind. I'd like to hear from you. Or you can share the video if that's your thing, okay? That's it for me, and I mean that wholeheartedly. That is it for me. Hope to see you tomorrow, fully rested. I'm either going to get like 4 hours of sleep or 15 hours of sleep. We'll see, all right? Take care. Bye-bye.